Okay, we talk about the basic project settings, about the pinout, about the clock configuration, and also the power analyzer. And now I will focus also on the more about the possibilities for the generation the project. For this, I will start the new project. I will here again select the F4, 401. LQFP64 pin package. I have the RE Nucleo. Then I will select this one. Now it's not necessary to choose anything. I will start with the blank project. Then the important part, which I am interested in here, is the project and the settings. Okay, here the project settings. In the first tab, as usual, I can put the name of my project. Then I here put the settings 1 to test first settings. You can set the location where your project will be stored. You see that the GroupMX create for you also the folder with the project name. You can select the toolchain, but you can select more. You can select the minimum heap size and minimum stack size. What is the difference? The heap size is usually the buffer or the pool, memory pool, which is used for the library functions. Usually the functions like printf, the sprintf, or the memory allocation, the malloc function, will use this heap. In case that you don't plan to use these functionalities, you can put here 0. And the stack is definitely used as a temporary storage during the execution for the local variables, for example, or as a temporary storage when you going into the functions. For this is used the stack. Too small stack can cause the problems. Definitely check if your stack and your heap is in line with your expectations. Definitely also check if your microcontroller has enough memory for your stack or heap. Then this was the first step. But I am now more interesting about the code generation tab. When I have the first part is here, the firmware library package. You know how to install the package. We install it through the help when you find your repository. But now also how the GroupMX working with this package. You can see that in the normal circumstances, in the default option, is to copy all used libraries into your project. What this means? The GroupMX, if I select, I in my project select no other peripherals, I have clean project, then he will use in my project only necessary libraries, only for the flash, for the clocks. But with this first option, he will copy into my project rest of the libraries. They will be not into my IDE, but they will be in the project folder. We can test this. Then I check this one. I click on the OK. And I will generate my project. Okay, I can open my project. Okay, and you can see in the drivers, I have only minimum files. I have here the timers, okay, RDC, only the peripherals which I need. But if you look into here, into my project, into settings, into drivers, into HL drivers, into source, you can see I have a lot more libraries. Then this is valid for the first option. Now I can do the similar process. I will do the save as. I will save the different project number 2. And here I will generate only my project only with the necessary library files. I click on the OK. I create my project. I will open my project. Okay. You can see in the drivers are the same files like in the last one with the first option. But if we look into my project, into settings 2, into the drivers, into the HL driver, you see there are only necessary files. This is the second option. To copy only necessary files, usually our package will be smaller. But in case we decided later on that we want to add more peripherals, we need to copy them on our own. Okay, I will create the third project. Here I select the last option. The last option is specific. This option will never copy any file into our project, but it only creates the reference between our project and between CubeMX repository. Then I here click on the OK. Now I will generate my code. And I will click on open. And we will wait until the IR will be opened. Okay. We can look into the drivers. You can see still the drivers like the last time. But if we look into our folder, into settings 3, you can see there is no driver folder. Everything is only the reference. We here click the right click, and I hope that here will be the path, then not. File properties, this is the correct one. You can see he's pointing into my repository. This option can be advantage that you can have all your libraries on the one place. In case that you change something in the libraries, it will be automatically reflected in all your projects. The disadvantage is that you cannot simply move your projects because you need also to copy the repository. Then be careful on this. Okay, now we can move to the next settings. I will save again, save as. I will create my settings number 4. I'm using mainly the copy all used libraries in case that I want to add something in the future.